A rookie robotics team in Kingston, Ontario, is making noise after they wrapped up their first high school robotics competition. The Machine Mavericks may not be the favorites to take the big win this season, but their goal to inspire gender parity and equity within STEM is praiseworthy. I joined them at their first competition.
It turns, drives to the...
After six intensive weeks, Team 7480, the Machine Mavericks, made its debut on the robotics competition scene. The team was put together in late 2018 by Olivia O'Driscoll and Ella Hsu, and they've been preparing for months for this moment. The first robotics competition.
Say hello, Team 7480!
Every day after school for several weeks, the team has been working out of their dedicated machine shop in Kingston. The robots weigh about 120 pounds, and students use skills in engineering, coding, and design to complete tasks on the playing field.
So there's about 80 qualifying matches, and we'll be competing in probably around 20. And in these matches, we get put with two other teams. We don't know who they are, and they change every match. So we'll have to adapt and work together with them.
The robot has a number of tasks. They have to put these covers over holes, and the holes prevent these balls from falling out, and they have to put the balls behind these holes to score points.
For their first competition, the team crammed their robot and parts of their workshop into a truck and drove down from Kingston to Humber College in Toronto. There are a lot of firsts for some members of the Machine Mavericks.
So we have started with some kids who never used a power drill, and now they're working on the milling machine and the lathe, making parts out of aluminum.
See these, which ones we don't need.
We also learned other skills like soldering, for example. I didn't know what that word meant just 3 months ago. I've been learning machining, I learned a bit of programming, and I learned how to work on this team, which is an incredibly important skill.
Ella's father, Ted Chu, is one of the mentors on the Machine Mavericks. They're one of 173 teams in Ontario. Success in tournaments like this means a trip to the provincials and then the championship round. While Hsu hopes the team will do well, they're on another mission in the science, technology, engineering, and math field, also known as STEM.
That means we're emphasizing gender parity in STEM. We want young men and women to learn how to work together well.
Can you close it?
You hear a lot of things about all girls teams, all girls this, all girls that, but in reality, when you grow up and you go into the workforce, especially in STEM, you can't find an all girls corporation.
The team is comprised of 14 members from four different high schools in the area, 11 of whom are women. To help spread their message, the team is openly sharing their secrets to success.
We have these handouts that we're giving out, which are about how do you promote diversity and inclusion on first robotics competition teams. And I really hope that teams can take that and learn from it and push their team to progress towards being more female.
As their name suggests, the Machine Mavericks are hoping to lead the charge in STEM. Along with developing their skills as machinists, they aim to make gender parity a focus at competitions, bringing equity to an industry that's been one-sided for far too long.
A successful technology enterprise is really a human enterprise, and it involves a lot of people learning to work together.
The Agenda with Steve Paikin is brought to you by the Chartered Professional Accountants of Ontario. Helping businesses stay on the right side of change with strategic thinking, insightful decisions, and business leadership. Are you on the right side of change? Ask an Ontario CPA.